Hey guys, and welcome back to a brand new episode of our detailed walkthrough on Dark Souls 3. So today we're on episode 4. Today we're going to be doing the Crucifixion Woods and the Road of Sacrifice. So there is one thing that we need to do before heading out though, and that is talk to Grey Rat. So once you've talked to him once when it's depressed and he's giving you the curl up gesture, you just have to refresh map by using a homeward bone or travel somewhere else and then come back. And he'll talk to us and say, would you like to send him out so he can go and find stuff? Go ahead and say yeah. And once we reset the map now or travel, he won't be here anymore. And he will come back once we've killed one boss. So the next boss we kill, then he'll be back here. I don't think there's anything else we have to do at the moment in here. Hawkwood's good for now. Anyway, we'll be coming back here a few times in this episode, so yeah, let's head out to Road of Sacrifice. Right, so Road of Sacrifice is actually a little area. We're just going to get through this in 5 minutes. We're going to find these new type of enemies. So we're going with the Bloodlust, though it's probably not the best idea, though it has got bleed. But if we've got the Longsword plus 2, then it's probably better, but I think it's cool. And we always do have the buff if we need it. Pick up the assurance stone. So what those stones do, if you infuse something and you're not happy with it, you can go to the blacksmith and use that, and you will reset it so it doesn't have an infusion, so you get a second chance on that weapon, which is pretty cool. I believe that was the first one we picked up. I don't think we picked any of those up before. Right, so there's nothing over here. Once they get their wings out, just watch out, because sometimes if they fly into you, they're going to do one hell of a spammy combo. The best thing you can do is kill them quickly and should be fine. Watch out for this guy. This guy's a mage version of him. Once you get close to him, he should be fine. I just noticed that this sword actually used quite a bit of stamina up. Right, so here we can drop down there, or we can drop down here. So on this platform, on New Game Plus 2, I believe, there's the Chloranthy Ring Plus 2. Could be the Chloranthy Ring Plus 1 on New Game Plus 1, but I believe it's the Chloranthy Ring Plus 2 on New Game Plus 2. Right, get these twin daggers. Watch out, we're going to be facing an NPC down here. The one we'll go is the Butcher's Knife. If you want to parry, just go ahead and use the Caestus. It's so accurate when it comes to parrying. It's just so easy to parry. It's not even funny. Go with a stab. Oh, he's not dead yet. No, he's dead now. But yeah, we'll get the Butcher's Knife off of her. I think we've got to pick it up. There we go. That's pretty good strength. Like it scales A with strength. So if you haven't found your strength weapon yet, you should probably go and try that out. Right, so down here, if we wanted to head back to the start of the level, we'd have to come up here above this bridge and head back over here. Watch out for these guys. Oh, it's not dead yet. And there's also a Titanite Shard here. What we're interested in, though, if we want to upgrade this weapon, is Twinkling Titanite, but we'll be getting some Twinkling Titanite a bit later on. Next episode, actually. So don't worry about that. Obviously, you can upgrade a Titanite, a normal weapon, as we go. So you can use it if you're having a bit of trouble, if you're using a unique weapon. So instead of heading across the bridge, what we've done is we've headed into this... Oh god, he just grabbed me. We're heading into this cave because if you're using miracles or your cleric can go with fate... Oh my god, these dogs are destroying me. I hate dogs so much in this game. I thought that he's bad. Oh my god. I thought it was bad in Bloodborne. I don't know how I hit that one, not this guy, but whatever. I'm probably going to die here if I'm not careful. Right. I don't really have much to heal, so I'm probably going to die. Sadly. Unless pick those things up. One's a tome and one is a ring that boosts miracles. And I'm going to get the hell out of here because I'm going to die. There's a bonfire just here. Up to our right is an ember if you want it. That item just there behind me is an ember. But we can't really do much apart from that. So I'm just going to head to this bonfire as quickly as possible. No, it's okay if we die now. Which we will. Right, so I'm just going to go ahead and use an ember. Right, so one really important NPC and one pretty important NPC. So this is Anri. He or she will always be the opposite sex than the one we choose. For a reason we'll be seeing a bit later on. But yeah, just go ahead and talk to her. And this guy won't really say much, but he will give us the item to get into the Blue Sentinels. So that's another covenant, the Blue Sentinels. What they do is, if you equipped it, I'm just going to give you a quick example. So if we equipped it, you should see that it's glowing white at the top left. That means it's looking, it's searching for a world to invade. So I'm just quickly going to take that off at the moment. I put the sunlight on. So when it's searching for a world to invade, that the host has been invaded by Red Phantom. And our mission is to protect the host and take the Red Phantom out. And that is what the Blue Sentinels do. So as soon as we take the Red Phantom out, then our mission will be complete. But we're going to head back to Firelink Shrine. For two things. We're going to find a new NPC and also we're going to be given the tome that we just found to the miracle, the cleric we saved last episode. So this new NPC, this is Ceres, and she will spawn as soon as we talk with Anri and Horace the first time in Crucifixion Woods, but at the moment we can't really do much with her. We will be talking about her in a few episodes time. And also we're going to go down and meet Irina. I never really remember her name. I think it was Irina, yeah, okay. And we're going to give her the tome we just got in Crucifixion Wood or Road of Sacrifice. And now we can learn the miracles from that tome. And like I said, if you want to do her quest, and once we give her all the tomes and learn all the miracles. Obviously not dark miracles, because like I said, if you buy one dark miracle off of her, it will activate her dark quest, and that isn't going to be much good to us. But if you learn all the normal miracles, then she will become a firekeeper, and she will be able to level us up, so it's good to know. I'm going to see if I can level one level up here. I need 6,000. Can we get 6,000? Probably not. Well, actually, I didn't really talk about trading in boss souls that well, to be honest. So we're going to go and see this guy over here. And we'll give him the transpose and kiln. And from this point on, we will be able to trade boss souls for certain weapons, rings, and spells. So for instance, if we wanted the Astor's Spear, we could trade in the Rotten Greatwood Soul, and he would give us the spear. But at the moment, to be honest, in this playthrough, we don't want any of this so far. So we're going to go ahead and I'm kind of a bit desperate for souls here, guys, so I want to level up once because of a certain NPC. So what we want to do is have 10 intel. Oh, we can't level up. God damn it. I know what I'm going to do. If I can find the shop. Where? Oh, it's for her. We're going to go to the shop and we're going to sell an ember for 1,000 souls, which is pretty good. Especially if I've got so many for invading people when I was getting these shackles. So, right, we want to have 10 intelligence, and I'll be giving you the reason for that in a second. We're going to go back to the woods at the moment. Right, so there's a few things we want to find in the forest, important things. So first we're going to head off here and pick this item up. This is the only way you can get this. It's a so-so, you don't really have to bother about it if you don't want to. Just take out this dog. This dog can get really annoying if you go around the other way, because you get caught up with the dog and all those enemies over there, and dogs aren't a pleasant thing as they are, but if they're with other people, then less so. So first we're going to head over here to the right. I'm going to try and get all the items here, just, I'm not really sure what order to do it in. Because the order I did it in the 100% item walkthrough was a bit of a long order if you've got all the enemies alive. Just watch out for these guys, they're quite aggressive. You can't really parry them or do much about them. These mushroom guys are the same as on Dark Souls 2. Crap, that was actually the mushroom's fault. Anyway, we're going to be coming in here. Don't worry about this crystal beast quite yet, because we'll be getting the other side of that gate next, no, not next episode, but next two episodes we'll be getting the other side of that gate, so don't worry too much about him. Up here is a set, I believe, yep, and this Black Knight, I don't recommend fighting him exactly, you can do. We're going to get the Twin Blades down here, and at the end we're going to get a quite important item that we want to take back in a bit to the blacksmith, the Pharynco, which is going to allow us to use poison. It's going to allow us to infuse with three different elements. I can't quite remember what they are. I think one was poison, lightning maybe? No. Okay, it was poison, heavy, and sharp. So we'll go over them once we go back to the black. So I'm going to give this guy one shot. But this guy, if he hits me, I'm probably going to get KO'd in one. It's probably going to be one of the most difficult battles you've had up to this point in the game if you try and face him. Try patience and it should work. He will drop your stuff sometimes, but normally he'll just give you a few souls, which is okay. We are out of Estus, and I want to pick one more thing up before heading back to Firelink Shrine. And then we'll talk about a few things. So the thing I want, just try and avoid the big crabs around this area. Oh, there he comes. I'm probably going to die against this guy. He's right where the item is, I believe. Yep. This guy is going... Oh, and I'm invaded by the NPC. Okay, the tome for pyromancies. The NPC is right there. I need to get back to... Firelink, thank you very much. I can't use him because I'm being invaded. I'm in some deep shit right now. There's not really much I can do about it either. Alright, anyway, one way or the other, we're going to come back to Firelink to explain two things. So, one, we can give the tome to the pyromancer, the one we just picked up, where the crab was. We're going to give him the tome, and obviously now we will be able to learn the pyromancers from that tome. So if you're going with the pyromancer, then it's always good to know. And the other more important thing was, we are going to give the coal of Farron, the one we just picked up, to this guy, and like I said, now we'll be able to infuse stuff with heavy, which will take away a bit of base damage and any dex stack, a scale, sorry, I always say stack, I don't know why, we'll take away any dex scaling and upgrade the strength scaling. That's what heavy does, so if you go on strength build, it pretty much will make any weapon better for your strength build. So that's what strength does. We've got sharp, which is the other way around. Instead of strength, it'll go with dexterity, so take some base damage down and take your strength scaling down, but it will give you better strength dexterity scaling. Then we've got, what else do we pick up? We have poison, so this takes a bit of everything away, but it will give it some poison, so it will poison the enemies eventually the more you hit them. So yeah, I think that's all I want to explain at the moment. So now we're going to go back to the swamp one more time, or the forest, sorry, because there's still a lot of things we need to explain. So the NPC who invaded us and eventually got us killed, we do actually want to kill him, so make sure you're in Ember form, because he's going to give his hat and also his weapon, and his weapon counts as a staff as well, which is pretty cool. It's going to piss me off. I hate it when you know that you can't kill him in like whatever amount of shots and they always stand with one health. Just like this guy again. But since we've explored the right part of the forest, we're going to come down here to the left hand side. There's going to be a few items. One's going to be just down here. It's not too many items, you can't really get lost. One's going to be directly in front of it over here somewhere. Down below all these guys. Oh god. And one of the more important, I'm going to try and, I don't want to kill you guys, so stop pissing me off. You get poison, yep, there we go. It's probably a good idea to buy some purple moss before coming to this place. I didn't buy some because normally I'd buy it next area, but it was probably a good idea. Though it doesn't matter too much, once we're past this bit then we're not going to have to worry too much about the poisoners. Just watch out for these guys, there's going to be a dog here to our left, which is annoying as hell. Normally he won't let his rest at the bonfire, what's at the top. These black dogs survive so much. Alright, once we've gone past all that crap, we should have probably came to this bonfire first actually before going around to the right, but like I said before, I wasn't really sure what order to do it in. There's going to be the grass crest shield down beside one of these trees. This one, I believe. Right, but before doing anything else, oh look, we got invaded by the NPC again. We actually want to kill him. But we're going to head back this side of the level to the left. To the left of the bonfire, if this dog don't mind its own business, thank you very much. Right, where is this invader? Ignoring the invader, who will eventually find him anyway. You come over here to the left. Watch out for these guys. And stick as far to the left as possible. Head past this building because down here we are going to find an Ester shard. So now we can have 7 Esters, maybe 8. I think probably 7. Watch out for these guys. It can be really annoying at some point. And this is an ember, I believe. Yep. So if we leave these enemies alive, they'll get up as soon as we go past them. So watch out. Well, you know. He may burn himself a bit first, if that's what he likes. I'm not sure if the other one will get up or not, to be honest. Maybe once we kill this guy. Gonna go ahead and pick these souls up, and we pretty much went round the building just to get the Estus shard mainly. Right, so we probably want to go and look for the invader next, without trying to get too close to those crabs. Normally he's around this area. You should see a little floating ball if he gets too close. Below this building down here, we have the Sage's Ring. Watch out for this guy. And watch out for the invader. Oh god. Watch out for the invader because it's probably going to be right behind us at this point. Sage's Ring over here. Nope. Sorceress. Okay, it's the other one. But whatever, Sage Ring and the Sorcerer set. Is he not showing up yet? Just watch out for the crabs, it's like the worst thing you can do. I don't really recommend killing the crabs anyway, like I said. They will only drop you a ring that will boost Pyromancers a bit. It's actually the ring that the Pyromancer starts with, so it's not the one that really majorly boosts it. Oh, there you are. Great timing. Now this crab's probably going to destroy me. I'm gonna get rid of you as quickly as possible. Probably shouldn't be using this weapon, to be honest. The Longsword plus 2 or any weapon we are actually upgraded would probably be doing a better job right now. Come on, crab over here. Take a good hard swing right there. One more. There we go. Thank you very much. So we'll get his weapon and his hat. And we'll get the hell out of here. You can kill the crabs, it's just annoying as hell. More the other one because it's in the deep kind of water. But yeah, so before exploring this building over here behind the bonfire, we're actually going to go to the left part of the map where there's going to be two NPCs over here. And the interesting thing about these guys is when we kill them, we'll get their weapons, so that's pretty good. We'll get the club and the Exo sword. Probably not a good idea to fight them both together, but oh, that's the Exo Sword. The Exo Sword is pretty much 90% what you're going to see in PvP for the next year, so get used to it. Really just stop trying to parry everything I see. Especially that, which you probably can't parry anyway. Oh my god. I like how he's just showing off the weapon art, that's all he does. Just to let you know how PvP is gonna work out. I believe this guy's got a miracle to heal. Yep, there he goes. Stopped him just in time. And we want to pick up the club from him. The great club. I'm not sure, but we may die against this guy at this rate. Especially if he gets too close to that crab. I'm glad he didn't continue with that combo. Oh shit. Die, please. There we go. That was really too close. I'm I'm suffering with this bloodlust sword right now. I really should be using the straight sword or the long sword, sorry, plus two. And I could continue upgrading it as well with all the Titanite shards I've got, but I'm actually saving them for a weapon we're going to get pretty soon. But yeah. Next episode, we will upgrade. We'll be getting some Twinkling Titanite, so we'll be able to upgrade the Bloodlust. So hopefully, it'll do a bit better. Mainly, I'm only using it because I thought it would be a kind of a more fun kind of weapon, a weapon that I've not really tried out before. But yeah, at the moment, it's not really working out for me. So, anyway, if you want to go back to filing and level up now, that's fine. This through here will be not next episode, but the one after next episode. But there's a few things we want to do before ending this episode. Obviously, we've got to kill the boss still, but there are a few other things we want to have a look at. And one of those things is the reason that we have 10 intelligence. So there's two ways into this building over here. One's directly behind the bonfire. There's like a little crack in the wall. I'll be showing you that in a minute anyway. And the other one is up here, up these stairs from the swamp. So in this room there's gonna be, oh God, that was great. Not the longest of katanas either. So if we head out this door here, halfway up the stairs, we're going to find a shield. I think it's the Falcon Shield. Yeah, Golden Falcon Shield. So yeah, we'll fall back down to pretty much where the NPCs are. So just go back round again. And into the building. There's one more little thing we can do in this room, and that is this time we're going to go all the way to the top. If you don't mind, watch out for the mage guy above him. This guy's more of just a distraction. Bye. Oh, you got a sorcerer staff off of him. Okay. But yeah, like I was saying, we can get a ring of sacrifice, maybe, I think it was, by jumping down here. Slightly hidden. Pretty much picked up all the items in this level, but maybe I think there's like one maybe in the middle of the swamp over there, and one exactly where we picked up the Pyromancer Tome. But nothing too important. They're at clear sight anyway. And this guy is gonna give us a crystal gem, I believe. Yep, crystal gem. So that allows it to infuse into crystal, but we'll be talking about that soon when we get the code to infuse it. So if we go right now, we will come to the boss area. If we continue straight, we'll eventually end up at the top of the boss area. So we'll be doing that in a second. So we're going to go around here first to our left. And this is really just to show you this. I think there's a staff down here. Yeah. The heretic stuff. But if you went through this building and came out this crack in the wall, we are right behind the bonfire. So there's the route that we'd take if we die at the boss. We'd go from this bonfire just here. But that dog really does not like to leave me alone. Right, so yeah, we're gonna head towards the boss, but there is one thing we wanna do before fighting the boss, and that is the reason we have 10 intelligence. So, just ignore these enemies, head across. Before heading straight on towards the boss, we're going to head left here. And come round here and head up these stairs. And here should be a right, and take a left, and there's going to be a new NPC. And he is a sorcerer, and he will head back to Firelink if you make a promise. But only if we have 10 intelligence. If not, he's not interested. Don't really worry if you haven't got 10 intelligence. As soon as you've got 10 intelligence, then you just go ahead and talk to him. Oh, missed that item. Nothing too important. I think it's pellets, maybe. I don't know. Yeah, he'll teach us some spells once we go and talk to him in Firelink. And yeah, now we're just gonna go out and head towards the Crystal Sage boss battle. Right, so the Crystal Sage boss at the start is pretty simple, really. He'll just spam a whole load of spells at you. And yeah, then he'll disappear every now and then. And then appear in another random corner of the map, which, yeah. All you have to do is get close to him and spam him a bit. And that's all we've got really to say. Oh, nice little bleed there. His second phase does get slightly harder, though it's still one of the easier enemies in the, or bosses in the game. I may have a bit of a hard time just because of the weapon I'm using. I should definitely be using, like, maybe the longsword or something. But since I went out of my way just to get this weapon, then, you know, I'm going to use it for at least this episode, and then maybe we'll see. It should probably do a bit more damage next episode since we finally get some Twinkling Titanites. But yeah, at this point, he will summon 3 clones every time he changes position. So the blue ones are the clones, you kill them one shot, so I really do recommend getting rid of them before attacking the original one. So they're just going to spam the hell out of you and you're going to get destroyed. That looks like I'm getting destroyed anyway, so don't mind. Can we bleed, please? Oh god, I really do wish this sword was slightly longer. Right, hopefully next time, if he bleeds, then it should be over. Let's hope so, because I'm out of Estus. Right, where are the copies? Right, mate. It's just me and you. Get that shit out of my face. And that shit. Oh, stop doing that, man. There, he's dead. Right. That was actually extremely closer than it should have been. But it's probably because I'm using this weapon. I'm not actually liking the bloodlust so far, but like I said, I've never really used it. I just wanted to try something new out. And make it a tiny bit more fun. Though, yeah, next episode we'll be getting some Twinkling Titanites. So we'll be able to upgrade it. Before ending this episode, though, like I said at the start, the first thing we did was talk to Grey Rat to get him to go and search the Undead Settlement, I believe he went to. And like I said, as soon as we beat the next boss, any boss, it doesn't matter if you go to the Swamp area and kill the Abyss Watchers, then that also counts. But we killed the Crystal Sage. It doesn't really matter. Maybe you killed the Crystal Sage, then sent him out. And you killed the Cathedral of Deep, or whatever it's called, boss. Then he'll come back. I do believe you've got to do it before getting to Irithyll, though. Because that's the second time we send him out. So, yeah. Yeah, so now he does sell better stuff, including the Target Shield and a whole load of other stuff. So, it's pretty cool. We'll be able to send him out again quite soon, but yeah, so we are going to go ahead and level up. Let's get a bit more strength. I'll explain that next episode why we're going for a bit of strength. But yeah, guys, that has been episode 4 of our detailed walkthrough. So yeah, guys, hopefully this episode wasn't too confusing. I did die a few times and maybe that made it a bit confusing. If I figure out that the bloodlust really isn't that good, even upgrading the next episode, then I'll probably change to another weapon we're going to be getting in the next episode. That's the reason I leveled up strength just now. And yeah, guys, so if this was helpful, please go like and subscribe. Remember, you can follow me on Twitter. Also, you can support me more directly on Patreon, which I need to give a shout out to Kevin for pledging $10. Thank you very much for that. And also, go check out the campaign I've got going on Teespring for my first t-shirt design. So hopefully that will work out fine. And yeah, guys, we'll see you next video.
Where to go from here is clear, I'm on my own. Yet I still feel off the chain like stolen bicycles. It was drilled in my head that I'm a selfish fuck, that I get on my own nerves when I talk too much. Told that I live my life disconnected and empty, with a smile that's insane as if I'm overly friendly. So do what you will, I'm still here and I won't leave. But look at how mean you can be, that is so sweet. Run for the hills, I'm as ill as your whole team. Drove off a cliff and I landed on both feet. Will I admit that I'm done with the old me? The dirtier it gets, the more I'm feeling I'm so clean. That I don't need Molly to be rolling with these changes. I'm at the library in a quiet meditation. Damn, people look pissed off and too abrasive, with lots of personality and no conversation. An epic name is who inspired me to thinking. I've hit the home run, I'm just rounding all the bases. I'm skydiving into your world design. The fire flying up from the earth will not be defeated. Hell is for freezing, scream till it's peaceful as walking on beaches. Laugh at how dark it can get in this place, as if you're eating the soul of a demon for strength.